Hey, how's it going, guys, and welcome back to the channel. Have you ever wondered how does a rim lock work and what does it do and why does it make it harder to install new tires if you have rim locks installed? If that's the case, stick around because I have in here a cut tire so I can show to you in details what's happening inside once you have a rim lock installed. Let's get started. So let me show to you what we are trying to avoid. So imagine you have your motorcycle tire mounted and you also have your tube inside. What we want to avoid is the slippage of the tire on the rim. So this movement here, we want to prevent this. It should be quite obvious why we want to prevent that. So here if you have the valve stem of your tube and now you have the tire slipping, and that's going to also pull together with it, or can pull together with it, the tube, the inner tube of your tire. When it does that, since the stem is fixed on a hole, if it pulls, it's going to rip out, it's going to rip off the valve stem, and then you get a flat tire. So that's the main purpose. We want to find a way to lock the tire in place so it cannot slip, and by consequence, ripping off the valve stem of your tube. So here's how the rim lock prevents that. First, I'm going to loosen a little bit this nut in here so the rim lock can move freely like that. Now let's simulate that we're installing our tire. The inner walls of your tires, they're going to have to sit on the inside. So the rim lock goes up like this. I'm pushing the rim lock up so it creates some gap for the inner walls of the tire to sit against the inner walls of the rim. Once it is in place like this, you see now that the rim lock is sitting against the wall. If I start to tighten this nut in here, it's going to pull the rim lock towards the bottom of my wheel, of my rim. And as I keep doing that, it's forcing the tire against the rim. So here it is, I've done that. So you can see I already cannot pull this out. Of course, here is the disconnected, but you get the idea. Even if I would just try to pull the tire like this, you see, it's already hard just for me to pull it like that, okay? So that's what the rim lock is doing, is just pressing against the inner wall of the tire and the inner walls of the rim. A couple of things you need to consider. When you add a rim lock, the rim lock also has a weight. Let me show to you the weight of the rim locks. So here's for the front wheel, 43 grams. And here's for the rear wheel, 74 grams. And by consequence, this is also creates some imbalance on the weight distribution of your wheel when it's mounted together with the tire and the tube. Therefore, usually you need to balance the wheel once again. If you don't know how to do that, I have a video here on the channel showing how to balance your wheel at home. Another point is that rim locks are supplied on different sizes. So usually you're going to have different options. And this size, it's related to the width or the distance between the inner walls of your wheel. Here you can see my rear wheel. And when I measure the distance between the inner walls, so right here at the center, not at the lip, at the edge in here, but at the center, I have in here, well, approximately 2.15 inches, and that's going to be in millimeters, about 54 point something millimeters. So that's exactly matching the 2.15 with this size. So that's how you define the size for it. And here now I have my front wheel. So let's check the same. It comes in at 1.55 inches. So once again, it is matching here. I have 1.6, but you know, it's approximately what I'm doing here. 1.5545 inches and 1.6, and this in millimeters would be about 39.5 or 40 millimeters. And finally, it is going to make it harder for you to change the tires of your motorcycle. Let me explain to you why it makes it harder, because I'm sure this will also help you once you're doing it. So here we have the wheel with the rim lock already installed. On top of it, we need to install this protective band for the tube. This protective band is usually going to have a hole, and that's for the valve stem. So what I'm going to do now, I'm just going to find where the hole is. So here is the hole for my valve stem. So I line up this hole in here this way. And then I put the tape around, or this band around, like this. And this band goes on top of the rim lock, this way that you see it in here. So it's going on top. When you're now trying to install your tire, you need to have this nut loose so you're able to push the rim lock up like this. If the rim lock is sitting against the rim, meaning I'm not pushing it like this, I'm unable to make the tire to fit inside all the way in of the inner walls. So I need to lift the rim lock and then the tire fits in there, the inner walls like this. And then once this is fitted, I can start to tighten the rim lock. So this additional step, as you're changing the tire, so your hands are already busy, and at the same time you need to push the rim lock up, fit the inner walls. Only once it is everything seated, then you can go and tighten the rim lock. And of course you have to consider that when you're doing that, you're also going to have the tube in the middle of everything, and you're unable to see the position of all of these parts because that's going to be inside. Here we have the tire cut open so you can see it, but when you're really doing it in real life, the tire is going to be covering everything, the tube is in the middle, and if you don't do this correctly and you start to tighten the rim lock, there's a chance that you might end up damaging your tube. So if you've never done that, take your time, and also here on the channel I have a video showing the step-by-step how to do it. So this video should make it clear for you what is the purpose of the rim lock, how to choose the correct rim lock and how to install it, and why does it make it harder to install a tire once you have rim locks. If you like this video, check out the next one that is also here on the screen. Bye bye.